Hi, my name is Chan Ryu, and I'm a software engineer at VESSL AI. Today we'll be looking at how you can quickly get started with VESSL on your machine learning projects. For those of you who are not familiar with VESSL, VESSL is an end-to-end MLOps platform that allows researchers to train and monitor models in scale as a team. In this video, we'll learn how to set up our first VESSL account. Next, we'll install the VESSL client on our machine, which allows us to manage VESSL resources through the command line and use the Python SDK in our code. Finally, we'll use what we've set up to train a simple image classification model using the MNIST dataset and track its results on VESSL. Specifically, you can choose to train your models in your own environment, or you can use the infrastructure we provide to train your models. We'll look at both of these options today. By the way, you can find all the commands in this video on our Quick Start page. First, let's log into our account. Once we've logged in, we can create an organization. An organization is a shared working environment where we can manage team assets such as experiments, datasets, and models. Choose a special name for your organization. I'll name it Chan Ryu Quick Start, and select the Asia Seoul region. Next, let's create a new project. A project on VESSL corresponds to a single machine learning project. You can think of it as a GitHub repository. Let's name our project MNIST and give it a simple description for our collaborators. Optionally, you can connect a default GitHub repository to your project. We'll see what that is in another video. Now that we have our account set up, let's set up our VESSL client. We install it using pip. Pip install VESSL will install everything we need. By the way, make sure your Python version is 3.6 or higher. Once that's complete, you'll get access to the command line interface using the VESSL command. To set things up, enter the command VESSL configure. First, you'll be asked to authenticate yourself. Click Grant Access to do so. Next, select your default organization and project. We'll use the ones we created earlier. You can check your configurations at any time using the command VESSL configure list. We can see that everything is set up properly. Great, let's move on to training our first model on VESSL. For this tutorial, we'll be using the training code that we've provided for you. Go to our GitHub page and look for the examples repository. Here you'll find several example projects that you can try out. Today we'll train an image classification model based on the Keras library using the MNIST dataset, which is in the MNIST folder. Let's download the code from GitHub to get started. First, let's examine the training code. You'll see that there's nothing too special here. We pre-processed the data, defined the layers of our model, and set some hyperparameters. However, we've added a few lines of code to be able to track our training experiment on VESSL. First at the top, we've added the line vessel.init. This tells the VESSL client that we want to record this as an experiment. Next, in the model.fit function, we pass what's called an experiment callback, which we've imported from VESSL, to automatically track Keras metrics and log image objects at the end of each epoch. It's time to train the model. Let's install the necessary requirements and run the code. If we follow the outputted link, we can view our experiment on the VESSL webpage. As you see, our experiment is up and running. On the Summary tab, we can get a quick overview of the experiment, the environment in which it was run, the command that was used, and so on. Next, we can view any output messages in the Logs tab. The Plots tab displays the experiment metrics. The experiment callback in our code automatically logged the accuracy and loss during training, so these metrics are displayed here. We can even view system metrics like CPU and memory utilization. Finally, the Files tab lists any files that were uploaded as part of the experiment. We haven't uploaded any files this time, so it'll remain empty. It looks like our training is complete. The nice part about using VESSL is that you can access the results at any point in the future, and so can any of your collaborators. So we've looked at how we can manage our experiments by adding just a few lines of code. We ran the code on our local machine. But what if we have some heavy-duty training that takes hours or even days to run? We don't want to be running those tasks locally. In that case, we can run it on the infrastructure provided by VESSL. VESSL provides computing instances with GPUs and sufficient memory for you to train your models. To use it, all you have to do is add VESSL run at the beginning of your command. You can choose an instance type with the desired memory size and number of GPUs. You can choose the container image, like a specific version of TensorFlow, or even a custom image that you've built. And there you go, your experiment is running on VESSL infrastructure. Once again, you can view the results on the webpage. So there you have it. We've explored different ways of running machine learning experiments and tracking the results using VESSL. We've provided a link to our documentation in the description box below, so make sure to check that out as well. Thanks for watching. Take care.